Have you ever wondered how the internet works? If the answer is yes, then you'll want to know about one of the core pillars of the high-speed internet we know today, fibre optic cabling. You probably know it as just fibre, not to be confused with the one that helps digestion. Fibre has helped the world connect like never before, letting people access gigabit speeds right from the comfort of their own home. Even with the rapid progress of technology and the growing popularity of smart home devices, fibre internet promises to hold up to our rising bandwidth demands for decades to come. Today, we're going to show you what it is, how it works, and why it's the gold standard for internet infrastructure, not just in Australia, but all over the world. First, let's get into the what and how of fibre. In its basic form, fibre optic cabling is made of super thin strands of glass or plastic that carry internet signals through pulses of light. The light bounces along the inside of the fibre using a concept called total internal reflection to travel at extremely high speeds. There are many of these fibres inside a cable, which are surrounded by layers of cladding and protection to reinforce it. Compared to other methods used for internet connections, like copper wiring or wireless, fibre is superior in almost every way. Copper wiring uses electrical signals to carry data, which can degrade easily over long distances. This often means these services can suffer speed and reliability issues. Wireless or satellite internet are both great options for rural areas without fibre access, but they have some downsides. These technologies can have high latency and are prone to being affected by bad weather. As fibre signals use light, data can go much further without signal strength degrading. It's also largely immune to poor weather, as it's usually nice and protected in the ground. The National Broadband Network, or NBN, uses either fibre or a blend of fibre and copper wiring to connect your home. Ideally, you'd have fibre all the way to your house for the best internet experience. However, most people currently have fibre up to a street node or pit outside their house, with copper completing the rest of the connection. Internet providers like us use fibre to connect you from the NBN to data centres, where all the internet content you see is physically stored. Of course, these can be situated anywhere around the world. With Australia being its own continent, we've got a couple of small natural barriers to overcome, like the ocean. But how? By huge submarine fibre cables, of course. Laid along the ocean floor and stretching for thousands of kilometres, these cables connect data centres to households. They're placed by cable laying ships, with the weight of the cable letting it sink and stay firmly on the ocean floor. In very rare cases, these cables are damaged by ship anchors or other man-made things, but for the most part, they act as a great habitat for marine wildlife. While we haven't laid any international submarine cables yet, we've got our own fibre network right here in Australia. The vast distances and differences in geography around the country mean that laying fibre is no small feat. There's no better example of this to show than our recent project, laying cable across Sydney's Middle Harbour, linking two high-traffic areas with growing demand. Of course, we couldn't just wake up one morning and go lay the fibre. The project took months of planning and preparation because of its complexity, including important marine wildlife protection. That's why we brought in a specialist team of divers. They were able to use an existing path of other utility cables across a 600-metre stretch of the harbour floor, leaving the important seagrass habitats untouched. Using a compressor jet to blow away the top level of sand, the divers were fed cable by a team above in a barge. Although the cable laying took just a day, refilling the trench took almost two more weeks of work. We had to make sure, after all, that the riverbed was returned to its original state, carefully replacing the sand manually. While it took about a year to organise the Middle Harbour connection, it's just one of the countless projects to come as the demand for more data grows. You might currently only be able to get NBN speeds in the hundreds of megabits per second, but the potential of fibre means it can handle into gigabit speeds and beyond. So every time you log onto your socials or sit down for a night of Netflix, make sure to give a small thanks to Fibre for making it all possible. If you want to know more about how the internet works, check out our blog center on our website and remember to like and subscribe.